But there are guys who stay up nights figuring out how to take that away from him.
I want to give you the truth, folks. The truth about America. I know you've got a lot of questions. You want to know why you're not getting the breaks you deserve. Well, I'm not a politician, but I've made it my business to study these things, and I happen to know the facts. Now, friends, I'm just an average American. But I'm an American American, and some of the things I see in this country of ours make my blood boil. I see people with foreign accents making all the money. I see Negroes holding jobs that belong to me and you. Now, I ask you, if we allow this thing to go on, what's going to become of us real Americans?
I've heard this kind of talk before, but I never expected to hear it in America.
This fellow seems to know what he's talking about.
Yes, he knows our rights.
What's the answer? What are we real Americans going to do about it? You'll find it right here in this little pamphlet. The truth about Negroes and foreigners. The truth about the Catholic Church. Now, friends, these books are free. Paid for by real Americans who want others to know the truth.
Excuse me, young man, but are you actually going to read that stuff?
Sure, why not? You heard what he said, didn't you?
Yes, I heard. But do you believe in that kind of talk?
I don't know, it makes pretty good sense to me.
I'm speaking to you as an American American. And I tell you, friends, we'll never be able to call this country our own until it's a country without. Without what?
Yeah, without what?
Without Negroes. Without alien foreigners. Without Catholics. Without Freemasons.
You know these Masons. People... What's wrong with the Masons? I'm a Mason. Hey, that fella's talking about me.
And that makes a difference, doesn't it?
These are your enemies!
A total fabrication.
Telecom companies. These telecom companies, ladies and gentlemen, there's the one in the Corey file, and we're going to be digging into this, all right? I'm going to give you this. This is the deepest research.
Made it up.
Not only has this research been presented to the appropriate legislators, but Michael Corey, when he revealed this to the people, the powers that be, and I'm not going to mention who they are.
A total fabrication.
They put him in a secure location.
A similar story happened to a young man in the Pacific Northwest about 20 years ago.
And he communicated immediately within the past 48 hours directly with investigators in Congress.
This one was invented by a writer.
Okay. Congress knows about this.
Not this time.
General Flynn knows about this.
It never happened.
Mike Lindell knows about this.
It never happened.
Carrie Lake knows about this. President Trump knows about this.
It's fiction. We made up this one.
We all know about this, and we're going to expose it.
Wrong. Not this time.
Picasso.
Welcome, bitch! In a dysfunctional home, you're going to have them.
Let's use the best ideas from both sides. Instead of fighting over who gets the credit, let's try sharing it.
Stone cold crooked, and you know it. His son walks out with millions of dollars. The kid knows nothing. You know it, and so do we. Go ahead, ask a question.
But the question, sir, was what did you want President Zelensky to do about Vice President Biden and his son, Hunter?
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, it was just a follow-up of what I just asked you, sir.
Listen, you ready? We have the president of Finland. Ask him a question.
I have one for him. I just wanted to follow up on the one that I asked you, which
did
was,
you hear
what
me?
Did you want
did you hear
to...
me?
Yes, sir.
Ask him a question.
I will, but
I've given you a long answer. Ask this gentleman a question. Don't be rude.
No, sir, I don't want to be rude. I just wanted you to have a chance to answer the question that I asked
I've
you.
I've answered everything. It's a whole hoax. And you know who's playing into the hoax? People like you.
Let's go!
Please secure the airlock and prepare the escape pods. Your Highness, the transmission we received. What is it they've sent us?
Hope.
I brought along my son Jonathan, who in the year 2001 will be the same age as I am now. Maybe he will be better adjusted to this kind of world that you're trying to portray.
The big difference when he grows up, in fact, if we wanted to wait for the year 2001, is that he will have in his own house, not a computer as big as this, but at least a console through which he can talk to his friendly local computer and get all the information he needs for his everyday life, like his bank statements, his theater reservations, all the information you need in the course of living in a complex modern society. This will be in a compact form in his own house. He'll have a television screen like these here and a keyboard, and he'll talk to the computer, get information from it, and he'll take it as much for granted as we take the telephone.
I wonder, though, what sort of a life would it be like in social terms? I mean, if our whole life is built around the computer, do we become a computer-dependent society and a computer-independent individuals?
In some ways, but they'll also enrich our society because it'll make it possible for us to live really anywhere we like. Any businessman, any executive could live almost anywhere on Earth and still do his business through a device like this. And this is a wonderful thing. It means we want him to be stuck in cities, we better live out in the country or wherever we please, and still carry on complete interaction with human beings as well as with other computers.
Imposed, and a world governing body will be created to enforce them. Crises precipitate change.
Secretly plotting your demise. I want to devise a virus to bring dire straits to your environment. Crush your corporations with a mild touch. Trash your whole computer system and revert you to papyrus. I want to make a super virus strong enough to cause blackouts in every single metropolis. Cause they don't want to unify us, so fuck it. Total anarchy and can't nobody stop us. You see, late in the evening, fucked up on my computer and my mind starts roaming. I create like a heathen. The first cycles of this virus I can send through a modem. Infiltration hits your station. No Microsoft or enhanced DOS will impede. Society thinks they're safe when bingo hard drive crashes from the rent. A lot of hackers tried viruses before. Vaporize your text like so much whiteout. I want it where file replication is a chore. Lights out, shut down entire White House. I don't want just a bug that could be corrected. I'm erecting immaculate design. Break the nation down section by section. Even to the greatest minds, it's impossible to find. I want to devise a virus to bring dire straits to your environment. Crush your corporations with a mild touch. Trash your whole computer system and revert you to papyrus. I want to devise a virus to bring dire straits to your environment. Crush your corporations with a mild touch. Trash your whole computer system and revert you to papyrus.
They have already planned. The plan is programmed into every one of my 1,000 robots. We will not hesitate. We will destroy the Homo sapiens.
Develop a super virus. Better by far than an old Y2K. This is 3030, the time of global unification. Break right through they terminals, burn them all. Slaves of silicon, corrupt politicians with leaders and their keywords. FBI and spies stealing bombs, dissipate their plans in their face and catch the fever. Everybody loot the stores, get your canned goods. Even space stations are having a hard time. Peacekeepers seek to take our manhood, which results in the form of global apartheid. Ghettos are trash dumps with gas pumps, exploded and burnt out since before the Great Union. The last punks walk around like mass monks, ready to manipulate the database or break through them. Human rights come in 100th place. Mass production has always been number one. New Earth has become a repugnant place, so it's time to spread the fear that's fun to some.
Too long have we tried to extend our glorious empire out to the stars, only to be driven back.
I want to devise a virus to bring dire straits to your environment. Crush your corporations with a mild touch. Trash the whole computer system and revert you to papyrus. I want to devise a virus to bring dire straits to your environment. Crush your corporations with a mild touch. Trash the whole computer system and revert you to papyrus.